We can live without designer labels, cars, the latest phone, and even electricity. But what we can't live without is food. We live in a country that produces more than enough food to feed its population. Yet many people don't have enough to eat. They rely on their local food banks and don't know where their next meal is coming from. This video will take a deeper look at these issues and how we are affected by them in our everyday lives. Let's think about food security and how our food system works. We need to have enough food available to purchase, and the food we eat needs to be produced in a way that sustains our environment. We need to get to where the food is and have enough money to buy it. The food must be enjoyable and culturally acceptable, and the food that we eat needs to nourish us, not harm us. The problem is that in many communities across Canada, this system is often broken. Meaning, if any of these factors were to disappear, the result would be food insecurity. Let's look at this system in parts. One of the largest barriers to accessing food is socioeconomic status. In 2009, over 794,000 people accessed food banks in Canada each month. And a staggering 2.7 million people will experience household food insecurity at some point this year. Canadians living below the low-income cutoff are at a higher risk of food insecurity for a variety of reasons. Because large grocery stores tend to locate themselves where they will be paid the most for their products, low-income communities often get left without sufficient access to food. These create what are called food deserts. Transportation also becomes an issue for individuals who cannot afford to access food outside of walking distances, or for those who are physically unable to walk at all. And to add to the matter, nutritious food that is culturally acceptable and full of nutrients we need to stay healthy is often more expensive and less accessible for people living in poverty. A large part of eating nutritious, healthy food is being able to obtain, process, and understand basic information about food. This is important because not having access to healthy food often leads to malnutrition and nutrient deficiencies. Statistics show that people experiencing food insecurity are more likely to become obese. Now, why do you think that is? Because in low-income communities, the food that is often most accessible is high in fat and high in calories, and commonly leads to diabetes and heart disease. Having available food on our grocery shelves is essential, but knowing where and how that food is grown is just as important. Eating locally grown and sustainable foods is a term that you may have heard before, but what exactly does it mean? Locally grown includes products that have been produced, processed, and distributed within the province in which they are consumed. Sustainable foods implies meeting current agricultural needs without compromising the ability of future generations to meet their own agricultural needs. Local sustainable foods benefits everyone, your local economy, your local community, and most importantly, your personal health, because freshly harvested foods have been proven to have a higher nutritional content than food that has traveled for days to reach you. In terms of the global food system, how did we get here? Unfortunately, millions of Canadians are still being deprived of their rights to nutritious, culturally acceptable food every year. So if this is the system and we know it's broken, what can we do to fix it? Here are a few things that you can do to address food insecurity in your community. Increase access to healthy foods through a good food box or a community garden. Support emergency food relief, such as food banks and soup kitchens. Organize a community kitchen and have a meal with friends. And finally, get educated and talk to your peers about our current food system. Have a conversation, blog about it, post information on your Facebook profile. For a more detailed list of ways that you can make a change in your community, visit us at www.mealexchange.com.